Thank you. the sound that they were hearing. Now is number seven. That's of course a wild woman. Very wild. Civil rights very fast. And what does he write here? Even faster. He writes these extremes in a tempo. In his second sonata, for example, he makes tempo markings. Zorash Vinodi, which means as fast as possible. Then, two pages later, he says, even faster. No, he says, faster. And then at the end, even faster. So if you start it as fast as possible, I many times performing that second sonata, I was thinking, what was really Schumann doing? He writes it almost everywhere. Fast, very fast, even faster. He is pushing all the boundaries. He is basically letting us know there are no limits. He was often with his speed, sometimes with the strength, the internal energy that he puts into music. So if he thinks as fast as possible, one could think, and if he asked people to play faster, I just realized, I can do more. I can play faster. There is never anything that I cannot try now. So that's the typical, I think, really boundary less romantic that you can even think of. So in some of these tempo markings, I see very often that this gets just to such extreme that one could wonder what he really saw. But it is possible. So here, this movement starts fast, and then at some part, he says even faster, which we almost feel like there is no safe era anymore to get faster than that. It's very difficult, and it's also, again, here it's writing in more than one part, definitely, right? So we have more voices to keep us around. What I would think is, although there are accents for the left hand, the right hand has to be helping. When you stop notes, right hand, you have to really work on your next finger to be more prominent. So, because there's a musically, doesn't it? bother you.